Hi, and welcome to this presentation called Cuisine Power for Anxiety Relief, Brain Health, and Physical Energy. I'm going to show you how to magnify your cuisine power, because too many people are exhausted. They got depression and panic attacks coming on, and yes, even overweight, and I'll deal with that as well. So I'm going to go over the magnification of cuisine power, and at the end, I'm going to give you my special secret recipe for beet vinaigrette salad dressing. Yes, I'm going to give it to you. You're going to love it, and it really dovetails really well into cuisine power. But first, hi, my name is Mr. Advocate. I'm the founder of Genesis Coaching Group. I'm a mindset, a relational and financial coach, a motivational speaker, author. I have a degree in economics and psychology from the University of Toronto. Okay, let's get into this. I'm going to give you actually 6 ways to magnify your cuisine power. Then I'll do the recipe. Okay, the first one is what I call equilibrium. Equilibrium is when you look at cuisine from a physical and a non-physical perspective. You're trying to bring the power of food, if you like, as it relates to the emotions, to your mental thought process, your overall mental health. And when you can bring those into an equilibrium position, you are going to maximize your cuisine power. And as I talk more, I'll unravel that a little better, for you. 2 is I want you to expand what we call the brain taste reward system. There's a reward system from our taste that goes to our brain. A lot of people's reward system is just sugar. It's donuts and coffee. When they have their donuts and coffee, they say, their brain says, yes. But it excludes maybe more nutritional foods than donuts and coffee. So I want you to expand your taste reward system to include at least 10 superfoods. Yes, at least 10 superfoods. Superfoods that normally don't go on a list as something great to taste like kale. Yes, you can actually develop a reward system to like kale at the same time. So I'm going to help you in this expansion of your brain taste reward system, and that's going to magnify your cuisine power. I would like you to consider all the foods that your body doesn't like, and I want you to start excluding them. Now, there's some severe ones, like some people, nuts they're allergic to, or dairy, or wheat, or gluten, or shellfish, etc. Those are sort of the obvious ones. But I want you to start really thinking, when you eat something, does your body like it? Do you get some energy from it? Do you think more clearly, from it? Do you have a sense of your anxiety going down? So we want to look at foods and start excluding them. Now remember, one size fits one. So I'm not going to stand here and say, do not eat dairy. Do not eat wheat. No, your body may thrive on wheat and dairy. Mine does. Mine does. I mean, people say, don't eat this, don't eat, gotta cut this out, da da da. Yep, my body thrives. I get more energy, I think more clearly, and a lot of them really are superfoods, except if you're allergic to them, obviously. So you want to start thinking of excluding foods that are somewhere between neutral, obviously, and negative, and start putting in more positive ones as we expand that reward system. Obviously, reduce sugar. That's number 4. Reduce sugar. Reduce sugar. Why? Obviously, sugar leads to diabetes, either 1 and/or 2. My wife has 1. She got diabetes when she was like 26, 27. I can't tell you her age or I'll get in trouble, but it's more than that. We've been married for 51 years. You'll have to do the math yourself in terms of what her age you might be. But anyway, sugar, and not that that happened to her, she just had a weak pancreas, but sugar can beat up on these weak areas. It messes with the immune system. It's a basis in which cancer likes to grow. Cancer likes to grow with sugar. You actually feed your cancer, if you have cancer, with sugar. Sugar must go. And I'm going to talk about a very simple sugar substitute that you might start with if you haven't already, done so. So reduced sugar is a big deal. Then more on this non-physical side, I want you to consider what your most tasty food is. I die for this taste. I live for this taste, whatever that is, and start associating that with a person, with a special person in your life. So if you coordinate the reward of food and a person, you actually improve the relationship with that person. So cuisine power has an impact on relationships as well. And in connection to that is cuisine power is associated with obviously celebrations. When you have a birthday party, a wedding, a coming of age party, any type of celebration, food is there. And there's, again, that's a community. It's a relationship aspect of your life. So the physical and non-physical elements of cuisine power needs to be looked at. So that's quick down and dirty. Let me just say them again. To magnify your cuisine power, think of equilibrium, the physical and non-physical. Expand your taste and your reward system, especially to include superfoods. Start eliminating foods that sit on the allergy side of your, just your body just doesn't relate well to it. Reduce your sugar. Associate your best meal with special relationships. And then make memories, celebrations with food. So food and celebrations go together, and especially when it's tied to the culinary art side of cuisine power and the hospitality side as well. The previous video that I did was on the culinary arts. You might want to look at that if you haven't seen it, because we're trying to coordinate cuisine power, culinary arts, and hospitality at the same time. Okay, the vinaigrette, the beet vinaigrette, recipe, for you, which is cuisine power. First ingredients, really simple ingredients. What do we have? We have apple cider vinegar with the mother, and I'll go over that a little bit. We have a non-sugar, sweetener that's least neutral. And I can tell you this is healthy, but it's least neutral. And then our extra virgin, olive oil. And of course, our beets. We got these puppies together. That's all there is to this. And when you look at the value of beets, which I'll go over with you in a minute, the value of apple cider vinegar, the value of extra virgin olive oil, you're going to agree that this is cuisine power in this dressing. And then when I tell you about what I put in the dressing, it's going to be like five superfoods in it with the virgin olive oil and the apple cider vinegar. This is a powerhouse. This is a powerhouse. Okay, what do you do? How do you actually make this? You take your beets. And obviously, you're taking the leaves off. And some are going to say the leaves are better than the beet itself, and I'm not going to argue that point, but that's not part of the salad dressing. You might do something, with the beets, and that might be another video. So anyway, you're going to clean up the beet, so you're going to take the top off and the bottom off, then you're going to scrub them, so you got three solid, beets. You take the beet, and then you're going to put it into a pot, and you're going to boil it for a period of time. And the way you know that it's done is you'll put your fork into the actual beet. And if it goes into the beet all the way, then you know it's done. Okay, so it might take like 45 minutes, 50 minutes, something like that, depending upon obviously the size of the beet. So we've got the beets, boiled in the water that I boiled them. I just throw that water out. So I got my beets, and then I'm gonna slice them, just in slices, just real simple slices, and all chopped up, just slices. I peel them first. Okay, the skin comes off really easily when they're boiled. So you can take that skin off, and then I cut them. And then they cut them up and they put them into a glass bowl. Why glass? Wow. You know, I mean, this will stain. You know, beet juice is, you know, it's the dye. So you want to wear something that if you splash it on you, it's not going to show. You're not going to wear white and deal with your beets. And you're not going to probably put it into any Tupperware because it'll stain the Tupperware. You want to put it into glass. So we now got our sliced up beets, you know, into our glass. And then we take our apple cider vinegar, you know, with the mother, and cover it, just totally cover the beets that are there in your glass. Then we take our sweetener, and then we start sweetening it until we get to your taste bud, a sweet and sour. We're looking for a sweet and sour flavor. So you're just taking the bitterness of the vinegar and modifying it. So there's a little sweet element to that you actually can detect with the same sour or bitter aspect of the vinegar. So it's a balancing that you're trying to do, you know, with this. Then once you get it to that flavor, your taste bud flavor, we get it in the refrigerator and let it marinate, you know, overnight. And then... what I do is I eat the beets, of course, not in the salad. I take the beets out. It goes into, you know, one of my meals. Maybe got some chicken and some broccoli and some pickled beets. So what you just made was really pickled beets first. Wow, those things to me are fantastic. And again, I'll get over into the benefits in a minute about these things and how they're going to impact on anxiety, on energy, you know, and brain health, you know, etc. So anyway, they're in there, you eat your beets, and then what you have left over is you have the juice, which is really the vinaigrette side to the salad. I then put it into another jar, glass, and I keep it there. And then I do not mix the extra virgin olive oil until I'm going to have my salad. So I've been doing it for some time, so I keep them separate, and then when I make my salad, I pour a little of this, I pour a little of this, mix it, pour this, pour a little, and then I do my taste. I do my taste at that time, so I get the taste of the salad that I want. And at least for me, this is over the top. This is a great taste experience. I really look, you know, forward to it. Okay, so superfoods, cuisine power, what do we got? Well, first of all, apple cider vinegar, what does it do for us? Well, it helps our digestion. It's an antibiotic. It helps in weight loss. It helps monitor, you know, our blood sugar. What do the beets do? The beets have vitamin A, C, K, E in them, the B complex, a lot of different minerals, you know, in them. They're going to help us with our energy. They're going to help us with our muscle stamina. They're the foundation to producing nitric oxide, which is the oxygen that's in our system. So they're one of the best foods to increase your nitric oxide. You know, so there's that, you know, in it. What is olive oil? And olive oil has an antioxidant, an anti-inflammatory in it. It helps with blood pressure, cholesterol, blood vessels, you know, cleans blood vessels. So all this stuff's going to give us the heart and health, heart and brain health, which is what we're talking about. So this salad dressing is going, first of all, it tastes great, it's cuisine power, and it has many, many benefits. The ones that I'm looking at for is my mind, my brain. My mind is really located in my brain and my heart. And again, I want more energy. And beets are really a fantastic source, you know, of energy. So this salad dressing is a power cuisine. And again, I'm going to give you then what I put in the salad. And it's really, as I said, over the top. Well, this is the message I want you to hear. I want you to start thinking cuisine power. I want you to think of the six things that magnify cuisine power and start with maybe a brand new diet. And I'm going to help you with that. You know, again, we're not going to be purist. You know, this isn't, you know, a health food in its own right, but it's going to move us in that direction. We're going to rise to our top with being very practical about it. We have budgets, you know, we have time constraints. Again, this doesn't take a lot of time. And again, you have multiple meals involved in this at a fairly low cost. You know, so this is a very efficient, you know, salad dressing to have. So I'm going to be very practical when I give you my recipes and then how to cook things at the same time. And again, I just want to mention the Climb to you. That's our product that we're developing for you. That's going to help you and your cubs mother bear rise to their top. So we're going to help both of you simultaneously, because whether you know it or not, both of you are connected. I know you knew that, but candidly, mother bear, your stability stabilizes your cubs. Your cub's stability stabilizes you. Neither one of you are going to rise to the top unless you both rise to the top. That's why we are advocates for mother bears and cubs in need. So the Climb is for both of you, and candidly, to do it somewhat together. So, you know, it's a unique rendering of how to rise to your top, especially customized for mother bears and their cubs. Again, if you like what you're hearing and whatnot, you want more people to hear it, just subscribe and the system will get the video to more people. Thanks for listening to this one. I'll see you on the next one. I'm going to talk a little more about hospitality for you and how to improve that area at the same time. Thanks for being with me on this one. We'll see you on the next video. Bye for now.